welcome to Saturday. Now, surprisingly for a November morning, it's not as cold as I thought it was going to be. So I've still got my short-fingered gloves on. Just gone for the high-vis gilet with arm warmers. And it's not too bad, you know. The sun is trying to come out, which will be a bonus if it does, because yesterday it was a beautiful day. I was up in Manchester, so I didn't get to make use of the sunny day, really. And I had a 5-hour drive back from Manchester yesterday afternoon, when it should only take about 3 hours. But hey, that's Friday afternoon traffic for you on the motorway. And then, I was so tired when I got in, went to bed at 8 o'clock, and had a good 10 hours sleep. Absolutely marvellous. Just such a great feeling getting out of my bike on a Saturday morning. And twice I've managed to get out this week, which is a bonus. And I have to say, after my 10 hour sleep, which is not normal for me, so I must have been knackered, I feel absolutely great, which is awesome. Such a great morning to get out on your bike. I've already seen and said hello to quite a few other bikers out this morning. I left home about 8 o'clock, or just before. It's now about 10 to 9, I think. I've just done nearly 10 miles so far, so hopefully I'm going to do about 20. And then later this afternoon, I still haven't had a chance to fit my Wahoo speed and cadence sensor to the bike to use on the turbo trainer, so I'm going to do that this afternoon, which should be good. People are okay and looking forward to your weekends. I'm so glad it's Saturday. Big thank you to you guys for watching my channel, subscribing to my channel. Yes, thank you so much. It really does mean a great deal to me, so thanks. And for all you people that follow me on Strava, thanks so much. I will put a link to my Strava. I know a lot of you follow me anyway, but for those that don't, I'll put a link in the description below. And also to my Instagram, because I don't think I've put a link to my Instagram under my channel before, so I will do that for this vlog. So if any of you want to follow me on Instagram, please feel free. The sun is out. I can't wait for it on a Strava segment a couple of minutes ago. It's just a long straight. So hopefully, I think I was second or third fastest recently anyway, so I'll have to double check, but hopefully I'm near to the top. Or on top. So I check. There really is nothing better than getting out on your bike, especially when the sun's shining and the roads are fairly quiet. Oh my god, it's just bloody awesome. I love it.
Hey, Good morning, guys. I hope you're all well. What a contrast to yesterday. It's Sunday morning. It is nearly 10:30. I've been up since about 6:30, something like that. And I was planning on going out on the bike. It's so quiet in the house here today. My daughter's working all day. And my wife's gone to work. And she's taken Gus and DJ with her. So my son's still up in bed, asleep. So I'm here with Honey and Noodle. Possibly two of the laziest dogs in Britain. Bless them. So it's so quiet in the house. Oh, I just have put some music on. But yeah, yesterday I was so full of energy and raring to go. Completely loved my 20-mile bike ride yesterday morning, which you'll see actually in this vlog. But this morning I just could not. Just in my head, I just could not get out the front door. I was going to go out for a. I had planned in my mind yesterday go out for a 30-miler bike ride this morning, probably about 7 o'clock. But that never happened. And then I was going to go out for a run, and I sat on. I got washed and everything, and I sat on the edge of the bed. And I was just sitting there, and I just could not sum up the enthusiasm to go out for a run. I really don't know what's wrong with me today. But, yeah, so I've not done anything. Apart from watch a bit of Match of the Day. Caught up with some TV programmes that I recorded in a week. Yeah, so it's been a weird morning. Just totally unmotivated. Do you guys ever get days like that when you just feel like, ugh? No, just can't do it. Anyway, I'm sure we all get those days. I am going to head out into the Shed of Wonder to fit this to the bike on the turbo trainer. Still haven't got around to doing it, so I'm going to do it now. So I'm going to film that and add that onto the end of this vlog. So you'll see my bike ride from yesterday. And then setting up the turbo trainer with the Wahoo Blue SC speed and cadence sensor, and we'll give that a try, see how that works.
Take this bad boy out of the box.
Here's all the fittings, as I think I showed you the other day. Let's have a look what we're here. What we got here, some gump, don't need to read that. So we've got a leaflet about setup, all pretty standard stuff. Right, let's crack. Magnet that fits onto you, so I'm just loosening that just so I can get it onto the spoke itself. That's the magnet fitted onto the spoke there. Now this lever here, there is a little hex nut there that you can loosen just so you can push that out more towards the magnet. So I might need to do
that. Seen that Woody Woodlouse has come to join in the fun. He obviously wants to see how this thing's been
working. Okay, guys, I've got it working. It is a bit fiddly to kind of set up just to get the magnet in the correct position on the spoke, etc. And I haven't managed to take my pedal off. So I've just slipped the Cadence sensor just over the top of the crank, but it seems to be working at the moment. So it's picking it up on that Wahoo app. I'm just going to try it on Strava now. But yeah, I hurt my wrist in the week carrying my heavy tool bag for work. So I can't put too much pressure on my right wrist. And there's no way I could get my pedal off, it just was not budging. So on the Strava it's picked up the Cadence sensor, but not the speed sensor, which is a pain in the arse. So I'll have to make a little adjustment.
Right, guys, I'll just show you quickly.
So there's the Cadence sensor, just right there on the end of the crank. As I said, unfortunately, I can't get this bloody pedal off, and to move the Cadence sensor sort of around in that position, just there. But I'll try that. I'll try that in the week. So here's the sensor, the main body of the sensor. I've just loosened that hex nut just to make the contact point closer to the magnet as it comes round. There you can see the magnet. And I just made a little adjustment and it seems to be picking it up on Strava. So the speed and Cadence sensor is working on Strava, which is good.
So yeah, I'll if I go on the turbo trainer later tonight, I'll let you guys know how I get on. But it seems to be picking it up okay. As I say, it's just a bit fiddly just to get everything in the right position, so it so the sensor picks everything up. And you've also got a couple of those cable ties, just go through the holes there, it's just to secure the whole thing properly to the chainstay.
Right, so that's it. I shall leave it here, guys, and I'll catch you later.